Students, today we start with a very conceptual topic of genetics, which is known as maternal inheritance. So, what is so special about maternal inheritance? From the terminology, you can expect that it has something to do with the mother of the progeny, that is the maternal side. So this is also another exceptional form of inheritance which does not follow the Mendelian laws. Before that, we have also had some examples which do not follow the Mendelian inheritances. Those examples are that of linkage, then sex-linked inheritance, and maternal inheritance. Now we know that an embryo or a zygote is formed by the combination of a male gamete and another one will be female gamete. The specialty of the female gamete is that it is larger in size and the egg cytoplasm contributes to the cytoplasm of the embryo. Another thing is that this cytoplasm also contains the factors that are released by the nuclear genes of the female. So it is very important. The other organelles which you have been taught, such as mitochondria and chloroplast, they are also having inheritances patterns, and those inheritances also follow the maternal inheritance. Why? Because there is also the presence of organellar DNA, which is cytoplasmic DNA, and the your chloroplast DNA. Now, the classic example of maternal inheritance has been explained by the pattern of shell coiling in snails. The scientific name for snails is Limnia peregra. So, if you observe in your garden sometimes, you will find these two type of snails. Say, one will be having a right-handed coiling pattern and another one will be having a left-handed coiling pattern. So this effect has been explained by the phenomenon of maternal inheritance. Now we will be coding the right as DD. DD also stands for dextral, which means right, and the left-handed will code as small d, which is known as sinistral, which also means left. And remember, the dextral is dominant over the sinistral. So before we proceed on to the crosses and conclude how the maternal effect has been explained with the help of those crosses, we will remember some very important terminology. First, let us recapitulate about what is a genotype and what is a phenotype. So, as we have studied in Mendelian crosses, for example, capital T and capital T small t, this is a homozygous and this is a heterozygous individual. Okay, so this and this are the genotypes, but the result of these genotypes, this also, if you see such a plant, this one also will be tall and this one also will be tall. So this, the external expression of the individual is known as phenotype, and the genetic constitution of the individual is known as genotype. Be very, very clear with this. And for then we will proceed with the next thing. Now, how the maternal inheritance was discovered was by conducting two reciprocal crosses. Now, first, let us consider these parents. One, Dextrel, and another one, Sinistrel. And we will be considering this to be the male parent. I'll use the symbol for this. And this as the female parent. This. Now, the progeny of the F1 generation is like this. If we cross this, then we will, in any case, we will end up with this combination. In how whatever form you cross it, you will end up with this combination. So, if we want to determine what will be the phenotype of this, we have to concentrate on the genotype of the female parent. Remember, a golden rule to understand the maternal inheritance is that the genotype of the mother, I'll just write it here, the genotype of the mother, that is the maternal parent, will always control the phenotype of the progeny in the next generation. This is a very important rule. Now, if we have to determine the genotype of this progeny, the phenotype of this progeny, that is how the, whether this progeny will be a dextral or whether this progeny will be sinistral, then we have to look upon the genotype of the female parent. So this is our phenotype and this is our genotype. What is the genotype of the female parent? This is capital D, capital D. And this genotype would be making a phenotype of dextral in the next generation. So this genotype controls the phenotype of the next generation progeny, irrespective of whatever is the genotype of this F1 generation. Remember that. Now, let us be more clear after selfing this individual. Selfing means we proceed to the next generation by selfing between this sort of same type of individuals. So, we make a cross between this and this type of same individual. So, this is dextral, this is dextral, and when we cross between these two individuals, we will be arriving at this type of individuals. As a result of this cross, it will be this capital D, capital D, then capital D, small d, capital D, small d, and small d, small d. Now, in the F2 generation, we are again supposed to determine the phenotype of these individuals. Now, to determine the phenotype of these individuals, what is the rule? We have to observe the genotype of the female parent. So, let this be the female parent, let this be the male parent. Now, what is the genotype of the female parent? It is capital D, small d. So, this genotype will be controlling the phenotype of all the individuals in the next generation, irrespective of their genotypes. So, all these will be dextral. Remember this. I hope there should not be any confusion arising in this individual, because this phenotype, that is how it is looking, it will be controlled by the genotype of the female parent in the previous generation. Okay. So, now let us do a reciprocal cross here. It will be more clear. So, what is actually a reciprocal cross? We consider the same characters, but interchanging between the male and the female. So, here, initially we had taken the dextral as female. Now, we will take this as to be the male. Now this one will be the female. Now let us form the F1 generation. So this is the dextral and this is the sinistral. Now in the F1 generation we will be arriving at this combination again, that is this genotype again, irrespective of however you cross these two individuals. So now we have to determine the genotype of this particular progeny. This is a result of these two parents. So if we go by the Mendelian genetics, we can directly write it as to be the dextral, because why? It is a heterozygous individual and capital D is always dominant over the small d. But this is not so. If we follow the maternal inheritance, we have to follow the concept, what is the genotype of the female? The genotype of the female is small d, and depending on this genotype we will be concluding the phenotype of the next generation. This will be sinistral. Please remember this. So the genotype of the mother is controlling the phenotype of the progeny irrespective of this genotype. So in spite of being your capital D, small d, this is individual is becoming sinistral. I hope this reciprocal cross is making it more clear. Now similarly, we again go for selfing between these two type of individuals, considering one to be the female and one to be the male, and then we again arrive at these combinations obviously. And if we are to determine the phenotype of these individuals, then what it would be, we will again go to the genotype of the female parent. So here this genotype is telling that it should be dextral, therefore all these individuals will be dextral. Similarly, when you it will be more clear if you proceed for the F3 generation, you can again cross this into this, that is selfing. Again if you cross between this and this, so you will be now able to apply this concept whether the next set of generation will be dextral or sinistral. So later on, when cytological analysis was done on this, it was concluded that the developing eggs has provided an explanation that the genotype of the mother determines the orientation of the mitotic spindle during the second mitotic division in the zygote, and this in turn controls the direction of shell coiling in the snails. Thank you.